Every day, millions of people are tracked online without their consent. Are you one of them? Corporations and governments trace and correlate your activities to build a profile about you. What if I told you that you can break free from the ever-present surveillance of the modern internet and browse anonymously? Anonymity enables people to express themselves without fear or scrutiny. Whistleblowers and activists in repressive regimes rely on the protection of anonymity to freely share their stories without negative repercussions. Vulnerable populations like domestic violence survivors and marginalized people need to access sensitive information. However, accessing this information could compromise their safety. Tor allows them to access information and lifelines that they wouldn't be able to safely access otherwise. Anonymity isn't only important for vulnerable people and activists, though. Everyone should be able to access information without fear of their browsing being tied back to their real-life identity. Tor, otherwise known as the Onion Router, is a free-to-use, decentralized network designed for using the internet with as much privacy as possible. If used properly, the network enables private and anonymous browsing and communications. Because Tor traffic is difficult to block and trace, it's an effective censorship circumvention tool. The Tor network is comprised of decentralized relays. When you connect to Tor, it selects three relays to establish a path to the internet, known as a circuit. These relays are operated by volunteers worldwide who generously donate their bandwidth to enhance the security of the Tor network. The more people contribute, the larger the network becomes, and the more challenging it becomes to monitor and spy on a person's internet activity. The entry relay, often called the guard relay, is the first relay your Tor client connects to. It can see your IP address, but not what you're connecting to. Unlike other relays, the Tor client randomly selects an entry relay and sticks with it for 2 to 3 months to protect you from attacks. The middle relay sees which relay the traffic came from and to which relay it goes to next. It can't see your IP address or the website you're connecting to. For each new circuit, your client randomly selects a middle relay from all available Tor relays. The exit relay is where your web traffic leaves the Tor network and is forwarded to your destination. It can't see your IP address, but knows what site it's connecting to. Your client randomly chooses the exit relay from all available Tor relays with an exit relay flag. Tor uses three layers of encryption to protect the data when it's in transit throughout the circuit. Each relay that the data passes through, a layer of encryption is added. This layering means that a single relay doesn't have visibility into the entire path of your connection. When you visit a website, your browser reveals quite a lot of information about you, like your operating system, browser, time zone, computer specifications, screen resolution, and more. This information can be used by websites to uniquely identify you and track you across the web. So even if your connection is hidden by the Tor network, you can be uniquely identified by your browser. This is where the Tor browser comes in. The Tor browser is a heavily modified version of Firefox that has been tweaked to make every person that uses the browser look the same. It uses advanced anti-fingerprinting techniques that obscure identifiable information about your browser, like your time zone, screen resolution, and more. For this reason, you should only browse the Tor network using the Tor browser. Otherwise, you'll be identifiable because of your different browser configuration. Tor also has websites that you can only access with the Tor browser. These are called Onion Services. These are websites with a long, randomly generated website address that ends with .onion. Tor Onion Services work like regular websites through Tor. But your connection goes through 6 relays before reaching the website. The first 3 protect your anonymity, and the next 3 protect the anonymity of the person hosting the Tor Onion service. Now, this probably sounds great and all, but Tor isn't a silver bullet for online anonymity. There are risks involved with using the Tor network and browser, so let's dive in. Tor browser relies on making all users appear the same to provide anonymity. This can be quite problematic, as bugs and security issues will be present across all Tor browser users. You might think that Tor is undetectable to anyone monitoring your connection. However, this isn't the case. An onlooker can easily identify you using Tor. Because the relays are public, Tor can help you bypass censorship, but it won't be able to help you evade being detected. It's important to note, though, that the content of your communications is still encrypted or invisible to the onlooker. Tor is an invaluable tool that everyone can benefit from using. We've all had times where we wanted to search something privately. Tor gives you that peace of mind. If you're interested in digging deeper, we have articles on our website, diving into the nitty-gritty of Tor. And with that said, what are you waiting for? Download the Tor browser today and access the internet anonymously. The more legitimate users on the Tor network, the less blocking it can be justified. Governments and corporations continue to invade people's privacy, and as a result, the Tor network's usage continues to increase. The Tor network wouldn't exist without volunteers running relays. Guard and middle relays are safe to run for most people, so if you have bandwidth to spare, consider setting one up to help the network. You can also help people in countries where Tor is blocked by running a Snowflake proxy. All you have to do is download the Snowflake browser extension. Be sure to subscribe to our channel to catch future videos that'll be just like this. We wouldn't be able to create informative and educational content like this without our donors and supporters. So if you found this video useful, please consider making a donation.